Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
One advice I would leave you with is that be persistent. And while it's a cliche, but it's true in all sense that nothing replaces hard work, and even better if you are doing smart work.
So here we are with another episode of the Conversations Cafe Online, a new season, new episode, new opportunities to interact with successful managers and leaders from marquee companies. I have with me today Pritika Jain, who joined Aditya Birla Group as part of the HRLP program in 2014 after her B school, and has since taken up various roles within the organization. Currently, the lead HRVP at Aditya Birla Housing Finance Limited. Kritika will tell us more about her journey and how has been her growth trajectory through stories. Welcome, Kritika, and thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Paul.
Right, Kritika, take us back to, you know, where you belong, what's your background like, and where did things start for you in the big bag world of MBA? And ultimately, how did AVG happen for you?
So I've been brought up in Delhi, and I did my schooling and graduation from here, and then went on to do my MBA from SIBM Pune. So those 2 years at college had been all about, you know, taking different kind of experiences through competitions, live industry projects, a summer internship, and the rigor of the entire academic course. And actually, AVG happened to me through a campus competition where I was adjudged the campus winner, and I got a PPI as an outcome of that. Later on, converted to PPI, and that's how, you know, AVG happened for me.
From choosing HR to going straight away to AVG from your campus, and now spending almost 8 years within the organization, how would you define your love for AVG?
I would define my love for ABG by sharing that learning never stops here. It is very important to have a good beginning, and being a part of the coveted leadership program, it gives you that trajectory to leverage upon the opportunities that are given to you. So this is a very good launch pad for starting your corporate career. But after that, what really defines your success is how you make the most out of the opportunities that are given to you, and you work towards those goals relentlessly. The first few formative years were focused only on taking different kind of experiences, like different projects, roles, and traveling across the length and breadth of the group. So ranging from plants to remote locations to regional office and overseas businesses. And throughout all of these times, I was working with diverse teams, leaders, and building a meaningful connect and network. I think all of these experiences, if I have to sum it up, have immensely helped me in growing into a professional, and learning never stops.
Absolutely. You know, you mentioned about your multiple stints that you took up. You know, let's get back to the first stint, you know, which was part of the HRLP program that you took part in from your campus. You were sent to Thailand, you were sent to Atlanta as part of the program, and you worked on different projects there. How was this phase of your corporate life?
Okay, so as per the design of the program, we did 4 stints across the business. The time when I joined, we used to have 4 stints, and the pattern was that we do at least 1 group HR stint, 1 manufacturing stint, and 1 international stint, and 1 business stint. And that's how it happened for me. So my first stint was with the Aditya Birla Financial Services, where I was working with them on an entire rewards and recognition framework and defining the behavioral competency. My second stint happened with the group HR. I was working on a project called the strategic purpose planning. My third stint happened to be with the pulp and fiber business, which was their manufacturing setup. Here I worked on the entire job evaluations and job description stint. And my last stint was with Novellus in Atlanta, where I worked on process mappings and process improvement for HR, you know, benefits stream. So if you see, overall, the way the program is designed is very robust and very clear.
You then moved to Sevagram for a role that was coming in right after your HRLP stint. How was this shift for you?
Honestly, a bit tough. But I knew this was going to happen. Again, it was a part of the design of the program, and nothing really came as a surprise to us. So I knew how I'm going to shape my career for the next 3 to 4 years in the group. We had to mandatorily do a plant stint after the first year, and it was totally a new experience. I think it was more of a culture shift for me. You know, from North America, going to a small town in the interiors of Gujarat, well, this also tells you the scope one must explore opportunities within the group, you know, from taking you from US to the remotest location in India. It was a big cultural shift, and I was one of the two women who worked at that plant, but never felt like I was an outlier. I would really get to meet a new person every day from blue to white collar. And that entire 1 hour, my trip to the plant from going to the entire, you know, integrated chain always added new perspectives to me.
You know, from this learning experience to a new learning experience for you, you next moved to finance, and, you know, we worked with Aditya Birla Finance Limited, where you held the role of zonal HR BP for digital lending and housing finance. Tell us a bit about this role. How did you maneuver through the changing trends or demands of that time in the financial sector that was coming in? And was it easy for you to have this transition, have this shift in your career?
I joined the business when HFC had just started its operation, the housing finance business, about a year or two ago. And later, after some time, I was overlooking the entire digital lending business as well. This was a new industry for me, and as an HRBP, I was responsible for the entire life cycle management of the employee. In this role, I was very, it was very important for me to be agile and at the same time be comfortable to work under an ambiguous environment.
You moved back to Atlanta, you joined Novelis again as an integration manager now. What were the few things you explored during this particular stint, and how did it shape you up as an industry professional in your opinion?
Okay, so this stint has been one of the highlights in my career so far. I remember when YTM, our young talent management team, approached me and shared about this role. Post my discussion about the role, and it was a very quick and a brief conversation where they just, you know, told me that, okay, this is a role that has come up, and what do you think about it? And when I completed that call, the first thought that I had was, wow, the group really knows how to give opportunities to their people. And I think I got to do a role which only some of the handpicked ones at ABG have got to do, and I consider myself really fortunate for that. So this was a role where I was a part of the core acquisition team, which was working on the acquisition of Alaris. This was one of the milestone acquisitions the group was making, and where it acquired this company for $2.8 billion, and this helped Novelis strengthen their global presence.
You are now leading HRBP at Aditya Birla Housing Finance Limited. Tell us a bit about the roles and responsibilities that you take up. What does your day look like?
So here I take care of end-to-end employee lifecycle, from acquiring talent to managing their career aspirations and ensuring how the HR strategy fits into the overall organization level business strategy. If I have to talk about the most interesting part of my work, I think this is getting to champion change management with the changing needs of the business. And this is a very critical thing to drive when businesses undergo changes and the impact it has on your people. One of the challenges that I constantly deal with is the changing the mindset, which doesn't happen overnight. And at the same time, it is very critical for the business to function.
Kritika, before we let you go, I would like to understand from a perspective of a student who is getting into a B-school right away, what are some of the things that they should keep in mind for choosing their career if they're not sure of the career path they want to take in?
See, these 2 years at college is going to give you enormous exposure through competitions, industry expert leaders, inducting sessions and, you know, seminars, summer internship, taking up live projects and field work, doing activities that is going to add a lot of depth into your resume. I think leveraging on all of these is going to help you build clarity on what you want to do. And post this, you will actually be able to define what your career goal is. One advice I would leave you with is that be persistent. And while it's a cliche, but it's true in all sense that nothing replaces hard work, and even better if you are doing smart work.
Absolutely. Hard work and smart work at the same time are the key, definitely, Kritika. Thank you very much for sharing your journey, your story. To all of the students who are watching this, if you want to get this opportunity of asking questions to young leaders like Kritika, do register for Conversations Cafe online. You would get an opportunity to ask any doubts, any questions that you have. Thank you once again, Kritika, for joining us for this session.
Thanks, Paul. Thanks for having me today. And it was great interacting with you. Thank you so much.
Same here.